Actually, Sapota is native of tropical America and is introduced from South Mexico to India. In India, Sapota cultivation was taken up for the first time in Maharashtra in 1898. In India, Sapota is now commercially grown in Karnataka, Gujarat, Andhra Pradesh, West Bengal, Maharashtra and Tamil Nadu. Sapota is also known as Sapotilla, popularly called Chikku, belonging to the family Sapotaceae. And the species is Manilkara sapota or Manilkara acras, or some people refer as acras sapota. The 2N chromosome number is 26, which is a diploid. The fruit is a fleshy berry, variable in shape, in size and weight. The skin is thin, rusty brown in color. The pulp is soft, melting, crumbling with a sandy or granular texture with 1 to 5 hard black seeds. Fruit is a good source of digestible sugar, about 12 to 18%, and an appreciable source of protein, fat, fiber and minerals like calcium, phosphorus and iron. The latex from the stem and immature fruits is used in the preparation of chewing gum. Fruits can be dried and made into nutritious powder, which can be used in milkshakes and sweets. Sapota seeds are used as diuretic, bark as tonic, antipyretic, febrifuge, and in curing biliousness and febrile attacks. We will now see the climate and soil requirement of Sapota. Sapota is a crop of tropical region, so it requires warm temperature ranging from 10 to 38 degrees C with a humidity of 70% relative humidity is ideal, where it flowers and fruits throughout the year. However, if taken to subtropics, or to the places of higher elevations like in Punjab and other places, it gives only one crop from summer flowering in April and May. Under moisture stress condition also, it produces one crop only. It can be grown up to an altitude of 1000 meter mean sea level. Sandy loams or alluvial soils or medium black soil with pH of 6 to 8 are ideal for Sapota cultivation. Now we will see what are the important varieties available in Sapota. Sapota tree can grow up to a height of 8 meter high. It has a strong trunk on which scaffold develop at regular intervals. Fruit bearing is on the new growth in axils of leaves. Flowers have 6 sepals, 6 stamens which are petaloid. The fruit is a berry. The fruit apicorp resembles that of potato. The fruit may be seedless or may have 3 to 5 black shining seeds. Sapota cultivars are grouped into 4 types based on nature of branches and color of the foliage. One is trees with erect growing habit. Branches appearing in ovals, leaves dark green, broad, oval, fruits large and superior. Second category is trees with drooping habit. Branches in ovals, leaves light green, narrow and elliptical, fruits small, inferior in taste. Third one is the trees with spreading habit. Here branches are irregular, leaves dark green, broad and oval, fruits medium to large, superior. Last one is the trees with spreading habit but with inferior quality fruits. In India, there are about 41 varieties spread all over the country. Some of the popular varieties we will see now. One is Kalipati. This is very popular in states like Maharashtra, Gujarat and North Karnataka. A popular table variety, leaves broad, thick and green in color, fruits oblong and round, born in single, fruit quality high with soft, sweet pulp. Main picking season is winter. Fully grown trees yield about 350 to 400 trees, fruits per tree. Next is the cricket ball. This variety is very popular in Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Maharashtra, West Bengal and Andhra Pradesh. A table purpose variety, fruits are large sized, round, sweet with granular pulp. Next one is the Kovan. This has been developed by TNA Coimbatore, a hybrid between cricket ball into oval, suitable for table purposes. The trees bear 4 years after planting, fruits are large in size, oblong, sweet, flush, reddish brown, weighing about 125 gram with a total soluble solids of 18%. Second variety is the CO2. Which is also recommended for Tamil Nadu state. It is a clonal selection from Baramasi, released from TNAU. The trees are medium in height, fruits oblong round, medium size, flush, soft, juicy, sweet, gritty, light brown in color with pleasant aroma. TSS is very high, 23%. Average weight will be 125 to 150 gram. Next variety also from the Horticulture College Periyakulam of TNAU, which is also very popular throughout India, is the PKM1. It is a clonal selection from Guddi, a table variety. It has got profuse bearing habit, fruits are medium sized, elliptical to oblong with thin skin, rich in sugars, TSS about 23%, average fruit weight is 80 gram. Then Pilipadi, this is very popular in Maharashtra and Gujarat, suitable for high density plantations, fruits are oval with rough surface, pulp gritty, medium sweet, average fruit weight is 400 to 450 gram. Next variety is the Pala, which is also a popular variety in the southern states like Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu. A high yielding cultivar, fruits are oval and egg-shaped, thin skin, born in clusters with apex broadly pointed and pulp very sweet with good flavor. Next variety is called Guddi, which is very popular in the southern states like Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu. Medium in height, conical in shape, fruits are elliptical, small brown, pulp less juicy, soft, gritty, brown in color with slight aroma. Bangalore, these varieties are is very popular in Andhra Pradesh. Large sized oval fruits with about 9 ridges running from the base to the apex. Next variety is called Kirti Bharti, which are very popular in Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu state. It is cultivated for table as well as for processing purpose. Very small egg-shaped fruit with 4 to 6 ridges on the rind. Skin is rough, medium thick with puff color. Pulp very sweet when fully ripe, ideal for transporting to distant markets. CO3, a hybrid between cricket ball and Vavilavalasa, released from TNAU. The trees are intermediate in stature, bearing commences from 4th year of planting. Fruits are dull brown color, oblong, sweet. Average yield will be 157 kg of fruits per tree. Now we will see the propagation method in Sapota. Sapota is propagated through seeds, which has been the basis of its variability in India. To have uniformity of the quality of fruits, grafting method, mainly inarching and air layering, is followed. Now seedling propagation has been totally dispensed in India. Approach grafting method using kirni, that is Manilkara Alexandra as the rootstock, is very popular in most part of the country. Planting and cropping system we will see now. Since Sapota is a crop of warm and humid tropics, it can be planted in any season provided irrigation facilities are available. But it is beneficial to plant the grafts in beginning of the rainy season. In areas having heavy rainfall, it can be planted in September. In light soils, pits of 60 into 60 into 60 cm size, whereas in heavy and gravelly soils, pits of 100 into 100 into 100 cm size are made in April, May and exposed to sun for 15 days. Top 30 cm soil is mixed with equal quantity of well-formed compost or farmyard manure, 3 kg of single superphosphate, 1.5 kg of muriata potash per pit are added for filling. To begin with, all sides and bottom of pits are dusted with 5% of BHE dust or chloropyrifos dust, and pits mixture is added to fill the pits. Remaining vacant space is filled with remaining soil to a height of 15 cm above the soil surface. Such pits are left to monsoon rains for setting, then planting is done at appropriate time. At the time of planting, a small hole sufficient to accommodate the ball of soil and roots of graft is made in the center of the pits. Since Sapota tree makes uniform all-round growth, square system of planting is recommended. However, in lands with 5 to 15% of slope, contour planting is recommended. Depending on the growth habit, Sapota orchards are planted at 10 into 10 cm, but being slower in growth, it takes longer period to occupy the allotted space. Therefore, high density plantation having 5 into 5 meter spacing up to age of 13 years are very remunerative. Thereafter, yields begin to decline. After care, young plants should be protected against sun scald by providing dry grass thatch on top and three sides excepting southeast for sunlight. Such well cared plants establish fast. In young orchard, weed hazard is common. Use of 2 kg of bromosil and 2 kg of diuron per hectare as pre-emergent spray is effective for a period of 10 to 12 months. Now we will see the training and pruning requirement of Sapota. A seedling tree grows excellently giving a shape of an umbrella. However, plants raised through enarching require training for appropriate shape and framework development. Sapota, being an evergreen tree, requires no regular pruning, but regulation of vegetative growth to improve productivity and quality of fruit is necessary. It is better to remove the lower most branches or the trunk up to a height of 60 to 90 centimeter, as they will be touching the ground and mostly unproductive. At times, thinning of branches is effected in old plantations. Pruning in Sapota is confined to open the tree to light and removal of dead and diseased branches. There is sufficient fruit set, but retention is low. This may be due to many reasons, particularly low auxin level in ovary just after fruit set, or due to sudden change in temperatures in December, that is low temperature, or in May, June, high temperature. The fruit retention can be improved by spraying GA at the rate of 100 ppm at full bloom and fruit set stages, or NAA at 300 ppm twice. It takes nearly 10 months for full maturity of the fruit. Sapota is a climatic fruit, hence can be harvested when fruits are still hot. Now we will see the water, nutrient and weed management of Sapota. Sapota is grown both under irrigated and non-irrigated conditions. Sapota requires irrigation at 30 days during summer. Insufficient irrigation results in dropping of flowers. Adoption of drip irrigation system is also beneficial, saving 40% of water with 70 to 70% of higher net income. This system should be laid out with two drippers spaced 50 cm from the tree during initial 2 years, four drippers at 1 meter from tree until 5 years of age. With the dripper discharge rate of 4 liters per hectare, the system should be operated for 4 hours during winter and 7 hours during summer on alternate days. Under short supply water, timing could be 3 hours and 30 minutes in winter and 5 hours and 40 minutes in summer. Manuring and fertilization of Sapota. Owing to evergreen nature of the plant, any inadequacy in its nutrition level to suboptimal level will affect the yield. Deficiency of nitrogen leads to yellowing of leaves from margin to midrib. The P deficient plants have purplish flecks on lamina with rusty pigmentation all over, and K deficiency causes development of chlorotic symptoms along leaf margins, which becomes dark gray in advanced stage. Zinc deficiency is marked by small and erect leaves, short internodes, and defoliation of terminals, whereas in calcareous soil, iron deficiency causes general yellowing of leaves with premature shedding. A dose of 50 kg of formulated manure, 1000 grams of nitrogen, that is 1 kilo, 500 gram of P2O5, that is phosphorus, 500 gram of potash per tree per year is generally recommended. This quantity can be regulated on the basis of age of the tree and status of nutrients in soils, especially P and K. Under rain-fed conditions, dose of nitrogen should be raised to 1.5 kg per tree. Castor oil cake is beneficial for high quality of fruits. Under rain-fed conditions, fertilizer should be applied before the onset of monsoon. However, under irrigated conditions, it should be applied in two splits. Total quantity of organic manures and half the quantity of chemical fertilizers should be applied at the beginning of monsoon and remaining half in the post monsoon period, that is September-October. Since 90% of the active roots are distributed within the drip up to a depth of 10 cm, nutrients should be applied under tree canopy and mixed thoroughly in soil up to a depth of 15 cm. In zinc and iron deficiency, the requirement should be met through application of organic manures and spraying of zinc sulphate and ferrous sulphate at the rate of 0.5% concentration. Now we will see the important diseases, pests and the disorders seen in Sapota. Sooty mold is a very important disease in Sapota, and it is caused by ascomites fungi, which includes many genera, commonly cladosporium and alternaria. It grows on plants as well as on the fruits. Sooty mold can be controlled by spraying Zinap at the rate of 40 gram in 18 liters of water, spraying starch solution over the affected leaves. The required concentration can be prepared by boiling 1 kg of maida, that is starch, with 5 liters of water. After cooling, dilute the solution with 20 liters of water. Avoid spraying during cloudy weathers. Next disease is the leaf spot disease caused by Phoya cephalea indica. The cauchal fungus results in dark brown adjacent spots on leaves. When infection is severe, the adjacent spots become large, irregular whitish patches. In severe cases, defoliation of leaves may be noticed. Control measure involves spraying of Dithane Z78 at the rate of 0.2% at an interval of 30 days. Grow resistant varieties like Kovan, cricket ball. Varieties of CO2 and Kalipati are tolerant, but Calcutta round are highly susceptible. Next, we will see the pest, leaf whipper. This whipper feed on the leaves by scraping the chlorophyll content. Caterpillar also bores into flower buds and tender fruits, leading to withering and shedding. Leaf whipper can be controlled by spraying Fosalone 35 EC at the rate of 2 ml per liter. Hairy caterpillars in a cluster on the stem of the plants could be seen during hot hours of the day. They are active at night, defoliate the tree quickly and collect on the trunk. The larva feeds on the leaves, causing defoliation. Hairy caterpillars are effectively controlled by spraying chloropyrifos 20 EC or quinolfos 25 EC or Fosalone 35 EC 2 ml per liter of water. Next is the budworm. The symptoms of damage include webbed flowers and buds, shedding of buds and flower buds, boring of holes and seeing of excreta on the attacked flowers. Natural enemies of the budworms like trichogramma, predators like lacewing, robber fly, coccinellids, spiders, red ant, dragonfly, praying mantis can bring down the population. Spraying of Fosalone 35 EC 2 ml per liter or phosphomidone 42 ml per liter or quinolfos 25 EC 2 ml per liter or carbaryl 50 WP at the rate of 1 gram per liter or neem seed kernel extract 5% control the budworm effectively. Stem borer, Isocrates tetranis. This stem borer, actually the grub of this stem borer bores into the bark of the Sapota trunk and feeds on the living tissues inside the bark. The chewed bark is seen on the hole. Control measures involves killing the insects by thrusting a stiff wire into the tunnel. Then pluck the holes with a wad of cotton in kerosene at 0.1% and plaster with the wet mat. This treatment creates suffocation inside the hole or tunnel, which results in death of the insect inside. Leaf miner. See, the tiny caterpillar of these leaf miners mines into the surface of young leaves. Affected leaves curl up. Mines are seen on the surface of leaves. Sometimes caterpillars are found inside the mines. Later on, affected leaves get destroyed, dry up and fall. Control measures involved one or twice spraying with dimethyate 30 ml in 18 liters of water or malathion 30 ml in 18 liters of water. Next is the mealybug, Pneumococcus isogyrides. It is a sucking pest, small in size, oval in shape with a cottony whitey wax. They suck the sap, secrete the sugary substance on the undersurface of leaves and base of the fruit near the fruit stalks. Leaves have a black coating which gives the name sickly appearance. Control measures involve spraying of dimethyate at the rate of 30 ml in 8 liters of water. Try to keep free Sapota plantation from red ants because they help in spreading the mealybugs from one tree to the another. Red ants are effectively controlled with the dusting of mixture of BHC 5% with sulfur in the proportion of 2:1 ratio. Kale insects are also noticed. Caterpillar webs and feeds on the leaves by scraping chlorophyll content. Caterpillar also bore into the flower buds and tender fruits, leading to withering and shedding. They suck the sap by infesting along the sides of midrib and surface of the leaves and twigs. Control measures, spray dimethyate or malathion at the rate of 30 ml in 18 liters of water. Natural enemies like Coccophagus cowperi, Cryptolamia has to be engaged. Then fruit borer, Virachola isocrates. These borers attacks on the fruits and sometimes the buds, which can be easily detected by seeing the latex which comes out of the surface of the infested fruits. Control measures involve spraying of 0.05% of malathion or spraying 0.1% of phenolate or 0.1% of endosulfan. Sapota also exhibit lot of physiological disorders. One is wilt or dieback is very common where Sapota cultivation is being extended to traditionally rice growing regions. Due to anaerobic conditions in monsoon, post monsoon season in such areas, wilt is of common appearance aggravated by fusarium fungus. This can be controlled by providing effective drainage facility before planting. The shape of the fruit is related with the number of seeds. If seeds which depends on the conditions for pollination and anthesis. High temperature and rainfall during flowering cause oblongation of the fruits. Sometimes fruits do not develop into their normal shape but develop a depression or furrow towards the calyx end. This symptom usually appear immediately after heavy rainfall and is increased by heavy aggravated irrigation. Therefore, moderate irrigation should be given. Fruits exposed to intense sunlight do not ripen uniformly, developing corkiness during winter. This is probably due to killing of hydrolyzing enzymes by alteration, moisture accumulation and heating of fruit surface in winter. Thus, its trees need to grow vigorously. Now we will see the maturity indices and harvest requirement of Sapota. The fruiting starts from 3rd year after planting, but the economic yield can be obtained from 7th year onwards. It takes about 10 months to mature Sapota fruits. Being a climatic fruit, it improves in quality after harvesting, but premature harvesting leads to poor quality. On the other hand, fruits harvested late soften quickly, resulting in spoilage during handling and transport. At maturity, the brown scurf on the fruit surface is replaced by yellowish corky brown color. The absence of green tissues and latex also indicates maturity. Peak harvesting periods are January, February and May, June in Maharashtra, March, May and September, October in Karnataka and Andhra Pradesh. The fruits are picked by hand or harvested with special harvester, which has a round ring with a net back fixed on a long pole. Yield in general, a fully mature tree 10 to 15 years of age can yield 1000 to 3000 fruits per tree depending on the variety and management practices. Regarding the post-harvest management practices, properly developed fruits have high TSS and sugar and reduced acidity, astringency and latex and vitamin C. Since Sapota is a climatic fruit, it has to be ripened artificially. Fruits are highly perishable and they undergo rapid ripening changes within 5 to 7 days, during which fruits become soft, sweet, develop excellent aroma with decline in tannins, latex, saponin, aldehydes and acidity. These changes are associated with increase in production of ethylene, rate of respiration, catalase peroxidase, PME activities. These changes can be regulated through chemicals, temperature and storage gas composition. Harvested fruit should be cleaned off latex and scurf by washing in clean water to make them look attractive. Such fruits should be graded into big, medium and small size. Fruit should be tightly packed in cardboard boxes of 10 kg capacity with rice straw as padding material and with ethylene absorbents and transported quickly to wholesale markets. In order to extend the shelf life and to avoid storage rots, fruits can be dipped in GA3 300 ppm plus Bevestine 1000 ppm solution at pre-packing stage itself. For uniform and rapid ripening, Ethopa 1000 ppm can be utilized at 20 to 25 degrees C. Ripe fruits can be stored at 2 to 3 degrees C with 85 to 90% relative humidity for about a month. Modified storage with 5 to 10% of CO2 can be employed for long storage, that is 21 to 25 days. Refrigerated vans, that is 12 to 23 degrees C, should be utilized for long distance and export markets. So, while summing up the crop production techniques of Sapota, Sapota, we have seen its other names are Sapotilla, Chikku, belonging to the family Sapotaceae, and the species cultivated is the Acras Sapota. The fruit is a fleshy berry, variable in shape, size and weight. The skin is thin, rusty brown. The pulp is soft, melting, crumbling with a sandy or granular texture with 1 to 5 hard black seeds. Fruit is a good source of digestible sugar, 12 to 18%, and appreciable source of protein, fat, fiber and minerals, particularly calcium, phosphorus and iron. The latex from the stem and immature fruit is used in preparation of the chewing gum. Sapota, a crop of tropical region, need warm climate and high humidity where it flowers and fruits throughout the year. However, in subtropical or places of higher elevation, it gives only one crop during summer months. Sapota cultivars are grouped into four types based on the nature of branches, color of the foliage, etc. Like trees with erect growing branches, trees with drooping habit, trees with surrounding habit and trees with spreading habit. There are about 41 varieties released and made available in India. Some of the important varieties are Kalipati, Cricket Ball, CO3, PKM1, Gutti, Bangalore, Kirtipati, etc. Sapota is propagated only by grafting nowadays. Important disease and pests are sooty mold, leaf spot, leaf pepper, hairy caterpillar, budworm, etc. It takes about 10 months to mature. Being a climatic fruit, it improves in quality after harvesting. At maturity, the brown scarf on the fruit surface is replaced by yellowish corky brown color. The absence of green tissue and latex also indicates the maturity. Sapota fruits can be stored at 2 to 3 degrees C with 85 to 90% relative humidity for about a month. Thank you.